Hello friends and welcome back to the Smart Exeter. This video is about singular and plural. I'm not talking about the grammar singular and plural when we change or add an S and it becomes some if to some ifs, if condition to ifs, and so on. So this video will be showing you what exactly is the difference in some ifs, count ifs, average ifs, max ifs, min ifs, and ifs. Now this is my database and you can see that if I want to see the category of ownership total, so what I will do, I have to make a filter, and after doing the filter I will be selecting the right positions so I can see this is as a total. So now if I want to do the same things, if I have to go to the subcategories and I can select each and I can see this. So this is the way the sum ifs help you, from sum if and sum ifs help you. So you don't need to do this, you don't want to, or you can do through pivot tables and all, but you can avoid those things by simple formulas, and that is sum if. Right now I'm showing you that. So I'll be doing the normal cell ranges. So let's do the sum if in the beginning. So this is a sum if. So you can see this is my database. So what I'll be doing is I'll be expanding this. And I want to see the total of ownership. So this is the main category, subcategory, and mini category, and this is the total. So main category, subcategory, mini category, and the total. So I just want to see own, as I showed you when I do the filtration. So sum if and if. So I'll be selecting sum if. Now the range. So sum if, the range is, the beginning is the range. So this is the range. So this is the range. B8 to B2 to D. If you want, you can lock it, but it doesn't really matter. And now the second is criteria. So what is the criteria? So this is the main range and the criteria is the same. So here I want to see the ownership. So this is the criteria. And then is the sum range. So what is the sum? What I am looking for? So I'm looking for the sum. So when I select this, and I can close the parenthesis, I can hit the enter button. So you will see that 21,760. So total, getting the total. So as I showed you, when you just select this and do the ownership, then you can select this is 21,760. So this is one of the reasons that sum ifs has been introduced. So now what is sum ifs? So this is for sum if. So what are sum ifs? So previously I've made a video on sum if actual and count if and all. You can see that in cells, ranges, and tables. So this video will be showing the difference between sum if and sum ifs. So now if I'm doing for two criteria, so two criteria are main category and subcategory. So I'll be selecting, I have to know what their data validation, so I'll be making this and a subcategory also. So for this, for the two criteria, I'm going to use sum if. So you can see sum ifs. So you can see that in grammar, when you have more than one item, it is, or many items, it is to be used as some ifs, not if. So I'll open the parenthesis. Here it's a different situation. In that one, you first had a criteria, but now you have to have a sum range at the beginning. So you can see you have to have a sum range first. So this is the sum range. Now is the criteria range. It's not a criteria, it's a criteria range one. So criteria ranges, this is my criteria. So this is the range. So if you have more than one, it will become a range. So now you can see criteria one, it's been highlighted, getting darker. So when I put a comma, this is criteria one. So criteria is one item. So here you can see FSCT is my criteria. And I put a comma. Then I want to have criteria range 2. So one or more items are range. So Now I'm going to be a subcategory. So this is going to be my criteria range. Comma. The second is criteria 2. So this is going to be my criteria. And I'm going to close the parenthesis. This is for two criteria. So you can see FSCTN is 235. If you want, you can check over here. FSCT. And here you can see 235. So now I'm going to do for three criteria. The same thing you will be doing is for three criteria. So now we have mini category fuel, solid, parking ticket, and cleaner. So we have this. So what I'll be doing is I'll be first doing the sum if. Some ifs, open the parenthesis. So this is the sum range, comma, criteria range. Comma, criteria is here, comma. So now criteria range 2. This is criteria range. It's very easy. If you have one and more, it's going to be a range, comma, criteria. This is the criteria. Oh, sorry, this is the criteria. So this is the criteria. So I'm selecting. I'll be selecting later. Comma. Now I'm handling for the third one. Criteria and third is this one. Mini category. Comma. And my criteria will be, mini category will be here. And I will be closing the parenthesis and hitting enter. Now I don't have anything here. So what I can do is I can select this. I can select this. Now I have, for these two items, you can see fuel, F is for fuel, salic, and cleaning and parking tickets. So I'll be copying this. You can have data management and I'll be testing here. You can see the fuel charges are 103. If you want to see salic, you can copy this, you can paste here, 100. So if you want to see in different ways, you can select the different criteria. So if you want to see MRO, and I don't think in MRO I have anything. So if I go to MRO, consumables and others. So if you copy this and paste it over here. Let me copy this and paste it over here. You can see 6. So I hope you got this idea of what is actually the purpose of sum if and sum ifs. So the same way it will be done for ranges, I'll be showing you in the ranges. And the same way I'll be showing you how to do count if and count ifs. So I feel this you got this logic behind the using of sum if and sum ifs and the criteria. So you can have as much as 255 criteria. So this is less like a grammar. So now is here I have selected 1 and 2 criteria, and here I have selected 1, 2, and 3. So you can have 255 more criteria. So it will be very clear. If you want to add, if you just add, keep on adding some anything, you can see that automatically it will be added. So you can see that whenever you want to add something, automatically when you have ownership, if you want to have things over here, automatically it will be adding. Now if you have fuel charges, so if you want to copy, if you copy this, Ctrl C, and if you paste this here, so you can see automatic double. Now if you want to remove this, so I hope you got this video useful, and thanks for watching this video, and please subscribe to my channel, please hit the like button, and see you in the next video. Thank you very much.